Hello friends, myself Ravi and welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will see about the important topic for the HTML tutorial, that is link. So let's dive into the tutorial. Links are very important tag that are used in HTML. It is used to create links between the pages. It is also used to create links to some other pages. So let's see how we can implement it. So HTML provide you one tag that is called anchor tag. Okay, so this tag is used to create the links. Okay, and this tag has one property that is called href. Okay, href is the property where you define to what link this anchor tag will bring you. Okay, so let's name this suppose visit Google website. Okay, and now in the href we need to provide the exact path of the Google website, which is https://www.google.com. So you need to provide the actual path of the website. Okay, and then you will navigate to this website. You also need to keep in mind that you need to put this HTTP or HTTPS before this URL. Okay, let's refresh it. So now you can see there is one visit Google website link, right? And if I click on it, you can see it is bringing us to the google.com website, right? But if you see one thing, we are not on our website. We cannot see now our website, right? If I click back, then I come to this web page. So if you want to stay, on your web page and open a new tab, and then into that tab, you want to open this link. So for that purpose, this anchor tag has one more property that is called target. Okay. And in the target you need to add underscore blank. Okay, so now let me refresh it. Now if you click on this link, it will open a new tab into that google.com. okay, so that's one thing that anchor tag provides you. Okay, now this is the Google, we have linked the Google website to our web page, right? Now what we can do, we can also navigate to some other files that are there into our folders. Okay, so we create different web pages, right, into our website. So we can navigate from one page to another page using this link. How we can do that? So for that, let me show you my folder structure. So if you see my folder structure, I have here two files, index and index one. Okay, these two are HTML files which are in the same directory. Okay, and I have one more HTML file which is in this R directory. Okay, this is demo app. Now we will try to link all these. Okay, so let me remove this. Okay, so if two files are in same directory, you can only name the file in the href. So suppose we are on index.html page and if you name it index.html, index1.html, okay. So now, and also change it to index one page, okay. And if I refresh the browser, you can see this link, right? And now if I click on it, it will bring us to the index one page. So if you see, we are on the index one page. I had already created index one. It has this content, welcome to index one, okay. So this is how you can link the file which is in the same directory to your index file, okay. Now if you have some files which is in another directory like the demo app, okay, so then what you can do, you can copy the path of this file, okay, and put it here. Let's create one more anchor tag and here give property href equals to, okay, give this path and change this to backslash, okay, and here give the name of your file. So suppose it is demo app dot html, okay. So now what I have done, I have linked this demo app html file to our index.html file, okay. So let me refresh this page. Let's also name it as demo app. Okay, now refresh it. You can see this demo app link here, right? Now if I click on it, now you see it brings us to the demo app.html page. If you go to demo app.html, I have already added one anchor tag here. Now in this anchor tag, what I have done, I have navigated back to the HTML page. So I have given the link of this HTML index.html. So here I have given the link to this index.html file. So if I click on this index.html file, it will bring us back to our index page. Okay. So this is how you can use this anchor tag to link your different web pages to one another. Okay. So that's it for links. If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please comment it below. I will definitely try to answer it. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel to get more updates. Thanks and have a nice day.